In PowerDirector 17, we can do motion tracking. They've actually upgraded that with the new version, and it's got a whole bunch of new cool things you can do with it, from adding images to text, to even the tracker works better. So let's have a look at that. We're going to drop a video down here in the timeline. Then we're going to need some music, so we'll put this down here too. And all I'm doing is grabbing it, dragging it, and dropping it. I'm going to line that red line up somewhere. Oh, just trying to get it near the end somewhat. I'm going to click the music, cut it out so that way it don't go too far. Click it on the end, hit delete. Now I'm going to back it up just a little bit because I want the music to kind of drop off so that way it just doesn't end abruptly. By clicking this arrow here. Oh, make sure I select. There we go. So you see, it added two keyframes and dropped the music down for us. Okay, back to our editing. While clicking on your video that you wish to edit, you will actually go to Tools and you will go to Motion Tracker. Click that and in we go. This is really easy to do. We want to start the video off from the beginning, so I click the big square so it's not way at the end. And this is actually where the video begins. Inside here you see this big square. We get to move that square wherever we want. So I could put it here. I could shrink it down maybe a little bit and put it right there. When I'm done, hit track. And it's going to stay there while it tracks away. When I want to stop, I just hit the stop button where my mouse is located here on the left side. I don't have to go through the entire video. I can stop it at certain parts of the video, like I can stop and say, oh, right about there. Now, I go up here and click text. Or, add an image. Or, add a blur effect if you're trying to blur out somebody's face. So click on text, and then over here, for example, I could type in satchel. So I've got the word satchel, but here's the really cool things they've actually added to this. And I do want to make this, the font, just a little bit smaller. I think the font's a little bit too big for my liking. But down here, we got a backdrop, we got a border, and we got maintain aspect ratio. The border has a real tiny arrow there. By zooming, you see that arrow right there? So we got a really, really tiny arrow there. We have to click on that arrow, and then we get a whole bunch of choices. So I can even change this to maybe like a gray if I want. And depending on how big, if I want to make the box bigger or smaller or whatever. Go up here, grab the box, bring it down here. I'll put it right on top of the satchel of what I'm trying to emphasize. And now I'm going to click the square over here where it says stop. I'm going to take us back and I'm going to hit play and see how this looks now. Well, maybe the satchel's, maybe this is probably a little bit too low. So we can raise this up a little bit. And a little bit more. And let's start over. Yeah, that's not too bad. Actually says the word satchel. So not too bad whatsoever there. Okay, so now I'm going to click the stop button again, go back to the beginning. And maybe I'll put one over here on this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another tracker. And you do that by clicking here. So I'm going to come out, add a tracker. And now I'm presented with another square here, as you can see. Let's move that over here. And we'll put it there. Let's start tracking. And we're waiting, tracking away. Here comes the big guy. And I think I'll stop right about probably there. Again, I'll hit text. I'll go here and I'll type the word bench, for example. Choose my font. Set my size. and then go down here and turn my backdrop stuff on to give me the look I want. And then move this down on top of the actual bench. Again, I'm going to hit stop, take her back all the way to the beginning, and then I'm going to hit the play and see what I got here. Looking pretty cool. Got the word satchel, got the word bench. Not bad. So I'm going to stop there a sec, and I'm going to go back again. And I want to hit the big guy. Here he comes, right about there. Maybe a little further, right there. Okay. Again, I'm going to add another tracker. This tracker, we're going to come on down here. And I want to get it right on this holster there. So then I'm going to start tracking this holster. See how it moved a little bit too far because it was grabbing his hand. So I stopped it and I moved it back. And I'm going to continue tracking. Not too bad. Looking pretty good. Looking really good. Okay, right there. So I stopped it. I hit text. And again, I'm going to type the word holster. Go back to here, hit sim, change the font size to, again, 14. Give me a backdrop here in PyroDirector 17. Give me a border, maintain aspect ratio. We need to move the word holster down, probably to here. Kick it to over here, not too bad, hit play. We could go probably up just a little bit is what we could do. So I'll go up just a little bit with holster. So not too bad the way he comes out, then all of a sudden it appears. It's following him. Motion tracker's working great in PyroDirector 17. And that's how we do some motion tracking, guys. Oh, we got this one guy. Wait, this one guy. Oh, we could track him. Why not? Why not? Why not just add another tracker to him? And then we'll start tracking him. And then when we're happy with it, we can actually stop it. And again, I can go to text. Wounded, same idea all the way through. And that is how you do motion tracking in PyroDirector 17 with their new options they've added. And as you can see, I don't know if you've used it in PyroDirector 16, but 16 seems a little bit buggy. You really got to stay on top of it when you're motion tracking. Where I've noticed in PyroDirector 17, I didn't have to stay on it as much. It looked like it was doing pretty good with tracking and leaving it. Now, you can get real fancy with images. I mean, if I was to open my paint program, make a little circle, make a line, and then a little box, you know, and type in a box and save it, I could use an image instead and really give that video a professional looking look to what you're actually working on. Like the video, guys? Hit subscribe. You want to see some more? And guess what? Guess what? You know it. I'll catch you guys on the next one.